behalf of Paul and Juliet, I want to welcome you to the celebration of love. They're a little bit nervous because today they will be sitting right up front. And usually they're back about three quarters of the way on that side. So this will be an unusual experience. Sometimes as we gather for marriage and celebration of the wedding, we look at it and say, they're too young. They haven't known each other long enough. Today we don't have those words.
Thanks.
We gather to celebrate and rejoice with them. And so take a moment. You probably know the people sitting in the pew with you. But take a moment, feel free to introduce yourselves to the people behind you and in front of you. So just take a moment to introduce. You guys stay right here.
Oh, hi.
Yeah, me too.
We do gather to pray. Loving God, you have made the bond of marriage a holy mystery, a symbol of Christ's love for his church. Hear our prayers for Juliet and Paul. With faith in you and each other, they pledge their love today. May their lives always bear witness to the reality of that love. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Invite us now to all, please be seated as we listen to God's word.
Another, as the Lord has forgiven you, you must also do. And over all these, put on love, that is, the bond of perfection. And let the peace of Christ control your hearts, the peace into which you were also called into one body, and be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, as in all wisdom you teach and admonish one another, singing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs with gratitude in your hearts to God. And whatever you do, in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
God is the Lord, the people he has chosen for his own inheritance. But see, the eyes of the Lord are upon those who fear him, upon those who hope for his kindness. The earth is fullness of goodness for the Lord. Our soul waits for the Lord, who is our help and our shield. For in him our hearts rejoice, in his holy name we trust. The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord. May your kindness, O Lord, be upon us, who have put our hope in you. The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord.
Please stand for the gospel.
Spirit.
Our reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to
the word of God be in our mind, in our lips, and in our hearts. Jesus raised his eyes to heaven and said, I pray not only for my disciples, but also for those who believe in me through their word, so they may all be one, As you, Father, are in me and I in you, they also may be in us, that the world may believe that you sent me. And I have given them the glory you gave me, so that they may be one as we are one, I in them and you in me, that they may be brought to perfection as one, and the world may know that you sent me, and that you love them even as you love me. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. So the readings that Paul chose begin with God's chosen ones, holy and beloved. And then we heard about the goodness of the Lord, and we heard in the gospel about becoming one. The idea of chosen. How do we find the right person for us? As you know, this relationship could not have taken place 20 years ago. But this relationship is possible because of modern technology. For the first time in my priesthood, I'm talking about marriage that began on Facebook. I knew that day would come, but I thought it would be two young people.
In spirit.
Not young of heart, people. Give me a moment. I have to give Paul a bad time.
It's okay.
We look at and see for 2 years on Facebook. 9 months before they actually met in person. He's such a quick mover. You are a patient woman. And we also know that part of this is that the government messes things up. So that they get through things and this is perfect. You know, a year for a visa, that's not bad, is it? You know, but love will persevere. Love will conquer all things. And then the Catholic Church says that's fine, but another 6 months is added on in preparation time so that we don't rush into these things. That we look at in a visit. And coming to know each other, and how important that was. But they had a very strong base because they were communicating daily with each other. And they had to use words, because on Facebook, Paul couldn't use his hands or lips. Which is often where young couples get in trouble. They communicate too quickly with their hands and lips. You paying attention here, Paige? Your dad wanted me to throw that in. How important it is that we come to know, and that you learn about, as the reading spoke about, compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. And patience. And patience. You learn about forgiveness. You learn how important true love is, and how to experience it. And how important it is for us, the marriage, and we'll hear as we go through the ceremony, that marriage is important for us as an example. Then the vows that you wrote, they wrote their own vows, they speak about the unconditional aspect. In a world today, we need good examples of unconditional love, of what that means, because we have too many people backing out of things too quickly. And so we look and say, that is important. Paul, why do you want to marry Julia? He spoke of her honesty. He spoke how she looks out for him, how she's caring, how she loves him, how she's generous, how she's selfless, how she's a true blessing. He spoke about the beauty and radiance of her smile. She brings him back to reality. He can't picture life without her. But she's determined. There's a great twinkle, spark in her life. How important that is that she completes him, and how generous she is. He loves her. Why do you want to leave the Philippines and come here? Did you think about this? She said that Paul was the most caring person I've ever known. That he loves me. That I know he will take care of me. That he's thoughtful. That he makes me happy. What she said next made me feel happy. I recognize that he's a goofball. But he's generous and pure heart, supportive, non-judgmental, positive. He overlooks my few flaws. They both spoke about their faults for a few minutes. And how important that is, that we recognize faults but do not dwell on the faults, but to look upon and see the goodness. When you gather around and look at the people here, the people that you have as examples, what do they teach us and show us about unconditional love in marriage? And there's a couple things. They also recognize they marry people with flaws, that we are human beings. But one of the important things is the good, loving relationship. Is that in a loving relationship, you always find a way to forgive the other person. God loves us. We hear that a lot. But how important it is to know that no matter what we do, God always finds a way to forgive us. I don't often tell people to try to be godlike, because that would be a heavy burden. But in this area, we need to be godlike. So when he's too much of a goofball, forgive him. When she's being herself.
Thanks,
I'm not naming any faults.
Thank you.
Forgive her. To see the goodness. We also see the joy in him. The very beginning, when I told you guys to take a moment to introduce yourselves to the people around you, Paul very seriously turned and looked at her and said, "What are you doing afterwards?" I think he has ideas. And so we'll ask you to follow up on those ideas. I ask the two of you just to stand right there for a moment. Juliet and Paul, you come here together. In this church, the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of the church community, your family, and your friends. Christ abundantly blesses this love. He has already consecrated you in baptism, and now he enriches and strengthens you by a special sacrament, so that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and lasting fidelity. And so, in the presence of the church, your family, and your friends, I ask you to state your intentions. Have you both come here freely and without reservations, to give yourselves to each other in marriage?
Yes, Father.
Will you love and honor each other as man and wife for the rest of your lives?
Yes, Father.
Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church?
Yes, Father.
Since it is your intention to enter marriage, I invite you to come forward and the wedding party to come forward as they declare their consent before God and his church. I told you that this is a technology relationship. So, Paul, pull out your phone.
Oh, you guys all want to hear this? Okay. My darling Juliet.
No,
oh, sorry. My darling Juliet, my tulip, my best pal, my partner. A little over 5 years ago, our family had experienced great loss and sadness, and I didn't know when I'd ever be happy again. And then you came into my life, and it started innocently enough, online chatting, emails, text, phone calls for months, plus the fact that you were an ocean away in the Philippines. And then you decided to come here to visit in the U.S., and right before you got here, I was really nervous. but right after you got here, I know, something just clicked. As we got to know each other further, I found that you were someone who has the same hopes and dreams that I had. Someone who believes in honesty. Someone who believes in putting others ahead of themselves. Right before you went back to the Philippines, you took a chance on me, and somehow, despite the time differences, the miles apart, despite everything, we made it work. When I asked your parents for your hand in marriage 2 years ago, I promised that I would take care of you. But in actuality, I found someone who will take care of me. Even in my worst days, you always find a way to bring me back to earth and make me smile. Juliet Mendoza Panganiban, I promise that I will be there for you on your best days, your worst days, and every day in between. I promise that whatever journey lies ahead, we will go through it together, side by side. I vow to honor our marriage unconditionally for the rest of our lives. And I want to thank you for being the missing piece of my heart that I have finally found. I love you.
My ever dearest Paul, my honey bear, my best pal, my partner. Today is our very special day. This day is a dream come true for me and the happiest day of my life because the Lord answered my prayer. For years, I have prayed that God would lead me to find the right man, the right partner, whom I will marry and share the rest of my life with. And I am very confident that His will has been fulfilled. I waited for so many years for this, and I can say that the waiting is so worth it. I know that there is no such thing as a perfect man, but I know that you are the perfect man for me, my perfect match. You are the most loving, the most sincere, and the most understanding person I have ever known. Every day you make me feel more complete, you make me laugh, you make me happy, and you make me a better person. Every day you make me love you even more. I never thought I could find a person that will make me so happy. We have been through so much, good and bad, and it made our love stronger. From this day forward, in front of our family and friends, I promise to love you unconditionally with all my heart. I will remain faithful to you, and I will always be here for you, just as you've been here for me for 3 years now. I will walk and stand by your side, cherish, respect, honor, help and encourage you for as long as we both shall live. I will love you very, very much, now, always, and forever.
You have declared your consent before God and His church. May the Lord in His goodness strengthen your consent, though you both with His blessings. What God has joined, we must not divide. And now we bless the rings, the sign and symbol of your love and commitment to each other. Loving God, bless and consecrate Paul and Juliet in their love for each other. May these rings be a symbol of true faith in each other, and always remind them of their love through Christ our Lord. Amen. Juliet, take this ring.
Juliet, take this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
Father.
And the Son. And of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Paul, take this ring.
Paul, take this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
And the Father.
And the Son.
The Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Now as they have been bound with the rings, we now place the veil.
To live this sacrament, they may share with each other the gifts of your love,
become one in heart and mind as witnesses to your presence in their marriage. Help them to create a home together. Give them children to be formed by the gospel and to have a place in your family. Give blessings to Juliet, your daughter, that she may be a good wife, caring for the home, faithful in love for her husband, generous and kind. Give blessings to Paul, your son, that he may be a faithful husband and a good father. Grant also as they come to your table on earth, that they may one day have the joy of sharing your feast in heaven. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Invite us now to please be seated as the gifts of the Greek are poured and presented to the chair of the table. My sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
And the Lord is thankful. Praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Amen. Receive, we pray, O Lord, the offering made on this occasion of the sealing of the sacred bond of marriage. And just as your goodness is in its origin, may your providence guide its course through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you have forged the covenant of marriage as a sweet yoke of harmony, and an unbreakable bond of peace, so the chaste and fruitful love of holy matrimony may serve to increase the children that you adopt as your own. By your providence and grace, O Lord, you accomplish the wonders of this twofold design, that while the birth of children brings beauty to the world, the rebirth and baptism gives increase to the church through Christ our Lord. Through him, with the angels and all the saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. I invite us to stand. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which you poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in the memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. And therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray, to partake of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered to one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Benedict, our Pope, with John, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome in the light of your face, and have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed Apostles, St. Francis, St. Clare, and all the saints who pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus the Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. I now invite us to join hands. And more importantly, we join in prayer as together we pray, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, O Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin, safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus the Christ. For the kingdom of power and the glory is yours, now and forever. Loving God, you wished your apostles a sign of peace. Our prayer for the two of you is that your home may always be a place of peace, a place of welcome, a place of comfort. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
In your spirit.
And a soft sign of God's peace first to each other. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say a word, and my soul shall be healed. so I invite you as husband and wife to receive the body of Christ. Paul, I invite you to serve your wife the blood of Christ. Juliet, I invite you to serve your husband the blood of Christ. Communion, I invite forward those that would like to receive. If you're not Catholic, you want to receive just a blessing. Put your arms across your chest, and we will give you a blessing.
Thank you.
Brother. It's Kelly. Mm-hmm. Brother. It's, no, that's... It's the son of Denise. It's Ken.
That's Ken?
Yeah, that's Kellen. That's, there's Kate. Gosh,
It's Deborah.
Oh, Deborah, okay.
Anthony.
Oh, okay. That's Denise, that's Drake's sister, and her sons.
That's Auntie Lele. Auntie Lele.
Yes. Yeah, there's Susan and Elmar's kids, right? There's Keelan, there's Elmar. Okay, those are the nephews of Margaret and Brody.
That's Kuya Lloyd's over there.
Yeah.
It's Edwin.
Right.
It's Edwin.
Edwin? Oh, that's Edwin. Yeah, he didn't pay for your trip. Yeah. Ended up having to pay for it. Yeah. Yeah, so what he did to me.
Party one more time. We have a final blessing, which is a very beautiful blessing. Juliet and Paul, may Almighty God and His word of blessing unite your hearts in the never-ending bond of pure love. May your children find you happiness, bring you happiness, and may your generous love for them be returned to you many times over. May the peace of Christ live always in your hearts and in your home. May you always have true friends to stand by you, especially in times of joy and sorrow. May be ready and willing to help and comfort all who come to you in need. And may the blessings, promise, and compassion be yours in abundance. May you always find happiness and satisfaction in the world. May daily problems never cause you undue anxiety, nor the desire for earthly possessions dominate your lives. But may your heart's first desire be always the good things waiting for you in the life of heaven. May the Lord bless you with many happy years together, so that you may enjoy the rewards of a good life. And after you serve Him loyally in His kingdom on earth, may He welcome you both to His eternal kingdom in heaven. May Almighty God bless you both, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And now a blessing for all of us. May the Lord Jesus, who was a guest at the wedding in Cana, bless you, your family, and your friends. May God, the Almighty Father, give you His joy. May the only Son of God have mercy on you and help you in good times and bad. May the Holy Spirit of God always fill your hearts with His love. May Almighty God bless us all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. My joy to present to you Paul and Julia. I got it wrong. You know it.
Nobody gets it right.
I did it so well in practice. Kiss the bride.
Scott and Mrs. Holly Martin. And Gracie Lagarde. Oh, no, no, okay. There he is, that's the brother of Juliet from the Philippines. And Grace, a college friend of Juliet from Bremerton, Washington.
Lovely assistant treat us with an opening prayer before dinner. So why don't we have you guys just step up right next to the bride and groom.
Dear Lord, thank you for this banquet you have given us today. Please bless Uncle Paul and Auntie Juliet on their new journey together. Also, please bless everyone here who came to join them on their special day. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen.
Thank you very much for attending the wedding. We've reached the... we've reached the toasting portion of the evening, and so we're going to begin with the maid of honor, Juliet's sister Alice. Please give her your full attention.
How's everybody doing? So I'll do my speech, and I have my cheat sheets. Right, here we go. I'm a crybaby, so bear with me. Almost a year ago, my sister left our home, her friends, her job, and many other things to be with the man whom our family equally love, that's Kuya Paul.
Love you guys.
You owe me money, Paul.
What else is new?
Since then, we only get to talk to her and see her via Facebook and Skype. We miss her every now and then. Most often, especially during special occasions. You know, in our family, she's our go-to person. She would always say to us, "Why do you have to ask me?" Or, "Why do you still need my approval?" That's how we are dependent on her. and that's how we value her judgment. But we have to let go of her at some point in time, right? Besides, she's given everything to us most of her life. And when I say everything, I meant everything. And even now, when most of us are already settled, we still are part of her dreams. I know this sounds really cheesy and melodramatic, but if there is an award, and I know that my other siblings would agree, for the most unselfish, most caring, and best sister in the world, that would be my Ate Juliet. I told you it's cheesy. They say nothing is more rewarding for a child than to hear her parents talk proud of what she has become, right? I know, Ate, that Ma and Tang rarely say this to you, but just as you know, each night before they go to bed, I always hear them talk about you, how proud they are, and grateful and thankful to God for giving you such a great man. We love you, Ate.
On a slightly different tact. I'm kidding. And the beautiful thing about this is I'm far enough away you can't see the asparagus in my teeth. They say the best man's speech is one part inebriation, one part inspiration, and one part humiliation. So, one out of three ain't bad. Chapter 1, The Early Years. One time in 8th grade, when Paul was buying a pair of pants... That's okay. There's always a backup. Fabric softener? Shopping list.
From the cuff.
Paul, I may not say it very often, but I couldn't have asked for a better big brother whose broader shoulders have always pushed things out of the way for the rest of us. I don't say it often enough, but I'm proud to be your little brother. And Juliet, he's waited a long time to find somebody to focus the huge wealth of love and generosity he has within him. And you are in for quite a ride. And I apologize in advance for all the embarrassing things that he and I are going to do together, because that's what we do. I'm going to borrow his drink because I forgot mine.
Okay.
To the happy couple, many, many, many good wishes.
Paula! All right, thanks.
Wow, so, I didn't think I'd ever get here, honestly, but, thank you. That's the love we were talking. That brief half second for Brian. No. I mean, I, for most everybody in this room, I probably have a little anecdote about each and every one of you, but we only have the room for so long. So I just want to say that I am entirely grateful. A lot of people have just known you forever, or just family, or friends, or I consider you like family. It's just a great outpouring of love for you all to show up and share our day. Some coming from all over, my wife's family from the Philippines, some of you coming from Canada, from everywhere. Why? But you know, I'm just grateful for everyone to show up. I just wanted to let everyone know. It's like we wanted to thank Alan, Grace. It's like if you didn't get on the internet and Juliet didn't see you there and say, and that conversation ending up having, saying, oh, I have a cousin in Portland, we probably wouldn't all be here. So I just thank you so much. Thank you, everybody, all of my groomsmen, Brian, Alice, Edna, wow. Thank you, everyone, for showing up and for sharing this great day. And just give yourselves a hand. Thank you very much.
Yes. I don't want to do a speech because I might cry. That's why I gave the mic to Paul. But I just wanted to thank everybody for coming here, for being a part of our very special day. That's they said that this is not the end. I mean, when I always say, like, finally this is the end of the wedding. No, it's just the beginning. So we're just beginning our life, starting our life together. And thank you for starting it with us. Thank you for being with us today, the first day of our married life, officially. And I would like to thank the Crick and Big family and the Panganiban family for being here. Finally, I was able to meet all of you.
There are only a few of us.
And our office mates, his office mates, my office mates, our friends, family, and my, believe it or not, I have an office mate from Manila, who came all the way from Manila. Yeah. Atinary, thank you. Yeah, and Pauline, thank you very much. Without you, all this will not be possible. Thank you very much. And Margaret, thank you very much, wherever you are. Oh, Margaret, my brothers-in-law, my family coming all the way from the Philippines. And I am so thankful, I'm so grateful. Thank you very much, everybody.
And I wanted to add one more thing. Mom, Dad's looking down and smiling. I love you. I love you, Dad. You'd be speaking to her in Kapampan all night. I know it, you know. So I know you'd love him. Love her. Okay. Thanks.
To step in.
Bye. Paul, great job. Why don't you escort your mother back to the table? I want all the married couples, all the friendly couples, boys and girls, let's have fun.
Okay, grab. There we go. We have a winner. Yes, we do.
Don't get down on that knee yet. We gotta get your helpful helpers here. All right, guys, back him up here. He needs support. Give this some thought. Come on now. Now he looks like one of those old-time photographers where you put the sheet over your head. I hope you're finding it. I really do. If you come up with anything different. Oh, we have a winner. One, two, three, let her go. Whoa!
Oh my God!
There's a shot.
Does she have a husband that's going to just beat the tar out of you? All right, take pictures. Here we go. We're up past the midfield. Oh, we're on the 30, the 20, the 10. We're going in for a touchdown right there. All right, there we go. Congratulations. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Boys, girls, ladies, gentlemen, cut in. You can cut in as individuals. You can cut in as groups. We can have young men dancing with Juliet. We can have young girls dancing with Paul. We can have the guys dancing with Paul and the girls dancing with Juliet. Doesn't matter. Come on up. Cut in as you feel free. Just jam on in there. Go ahead and grab on. Let's get this thing going here. Hands full there. Not only is she good on a microphone, but she can swing up a storm. If you're not dancing, you should be taking pictures. We've got cameras on the table. If you brought one with you, shoot away. You can do that as well. Like I say, there are no rules. Okay, to change it up a little bit. Don't want to wear you out. We've got plenty of music coming. Keep it going.
For a day.